Hi guys, so hope everybody is having a good Friday. Today I'll be having a guest who is Lakshita, and she's a wonderful painter and artist. So I'll just wait for Lakshita to join and then I can introduce her more. Hi Mamta. I'm just waiting for Lakshita to join and then okay. Hi Lakshita.
Hi, just a minute. How can I turn this?
You get a camera option, so you can just turn the camera to face you. Hi, I can see you. Hi, Divya. So I was just introducing you. Lakshita is an amazing artist who is also a PhD student. She has so many talents. Yeah, just to start off with, Lakshita, what do you do and where do you come from? Can you give a little bit of background about yourself?
Okay, so I'm from Bangalore, India. So I have done my bachelor's and master's in science and I've specialized in physics and astrophysics. So currently I'm pursuing my PhD in astrophysics. Like, I study the sun and its atmosphere, trying to understand what elements are present there and how it changes.
No wonder your paintings are related to all the astronomy, and that's what astrophysics is it about.
Yes. Yeah. I love painting the stars and the sky and everything, any natural phenomenon actually. Like, I don't like painting human-made objects. I usually focus on trees and mountains and lightning, stars, galaxies.
That's amazing. So why did you develop this interest in astrophysics and even astronomy and other sun, stars and everything?
I think every child would find astrophysics fascinating when they are little, but only a few pursue that as a career. So I have always had that passion, that curiosity to learn more, and my parents actually encouraged me quite well.
Yeah.
So whenever I was stuck and I didn't know how to move forward, they took me to institutes. They made sure I met with scientists to figure out how to move forward in this. So I think I was lucky in that way. So, and I just continued my passion that I had as a child.
That's so cool, actually. Coming back to this art thing. So where did you develop that interest, and when did you actually feel that, okay, I should become an artist and I should start painting whatever I see?
My mother tells me stories when I was 2 and 3 years old. I used to paint on all the invitation cards that we used to get. But obviously, I don't remember that. But one incident that I do remember quite well is when I was in my third standard, we had an All India competition, drawing competition. And I had painted this autumn scene where there was a big tree and a girl was sitting below that, and all flowers and leaves were falling around her. And I actually won first prize for that in my age category. And I think I actually got to know that I am quite good at this. So I continued this. And last year, I thought maybe I can take it up as a career as well, maybe I can get more people to see my art. And at that time I saw the Flaunter art advertisement, because I used to follow you because of your travels.
Yeah,
and I think that just clicked, I wanted to do that, and you people just posted it at the same time.
That worked out really well for both of us, for you and for us, actually. And so going back to your autumn scene that you had actually painted, do you still have it?
Mm-hmm. No, we had to send it to Delhi and they kept it. I don't have it.
Okay. What did you win as first prize?
I got a gold medal and my name in the local newspaper. So my parents still keep that with them, the article, newspaper article.
That's really cool. Yeah. So art itself, what is a medium that you use, and which one do you enjoy the most?
I enjoy mostly acrylics because I haven't tried oil yet, but compared to watercolors and pastel colors, whatever, I think acrylic gives more freedom to it. I mean, like we can actually put a lot of layers to the painting, and we can feel we can capture the depth in the paintings. Like when, let's say, I'm painting a galaxy, there are so many stars that are quite far away, and that appears as very faint and dull. In watercolors, it's quite difficult to capture that, I feel, but in acrylic, it's very beautiful. It comes out very beautifully.
Yeah, so, that's true. Yeah, even I enjoy acrylic a lot. I have just started doing watercolors. I always said that watercolors don't listen to me. They just keep flowing everywhere. So, yeah, I've just started it from yesterday. So I've been practicing a bit of landscapes and stuff. But then, yeah, I love acrylics as well. That's really good.
Do you do oil paints as well?
No, I haven't tried those. So it's just acrylic and water. I have tried oil some time back, a long time back. Mm-hmm. But then other than that, only once I had tried oil. Not more than that. So I don't have a formal training. I just try like looking at the videos and stuff. So speaking of training, what about you? Like, where do you learn your art from?
Right now, I last year I used to watch a lot of YouTube videos. So they give me a lot, a good idea on how to mix colors, and if I want to, if I want to paint some particular scenario like the sunset or sunrise or water, I watched a lot of tutorials. So they give me a pretty good idea on how to go about it. So now what I do is whenever I want to paint something, if I have something in mind, I try to apply all those techniques and maybe develop a few of my own. So even I'm not, professionally trained in this. I just do it out of passion, and it's coming out quite good, I feel.
Do you have any favorite YouTuber whom you follow a lot?
Yeah, there's this one channel, Stay Creative Painting with Ryan Rohrkiri.
Okay.
He's amazing. Like he gives very in-depth details about everything. Like his painting tutorials are usually like 2 hours, 3 hours long.
Wow.
And he does everything live. So even the mixing of each and every color, he shows us and he tells us why we need to mix this color. Like if we mix white, it brings out, it saturates the color, and like when we should use black and everything. So yeah, I follow him quite a lot.
That's really cool. That's really nice. So the kind of paintings that you have done so far, which one is your favorite?
I don't have a favorite, but maybe the cosmic one.
Cosmic one, yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, many people asked about that as well. It gives that kind of magical feeling, isn't it? It feels like as if you're in some other world. Yeah, that's true. It's very beautiful. Yeah, so did you do it just by thinking about it? What inspired you to do that?
I had read a book just before painting that. It's called Where the Forest Meets the Stars. And that book had a cover similar to that painting I have made.
Ah, okay.
So I just modified it a little bit and then I did it.
Okay. That's interesting to know. Yeah. So, Lakshita, going back, if, for example, somebody has to just pick it up, like an artist who's been painting for their own passion, and they want to actually pursue for their career, what advice would you give it to them?
As a career?
Yeah.
I mean, first they'll need to understand what kind of paintings they like. I tried a lot of varieties. You know, I first tried sketching. And then I figured out it's not my forte. And then I did like traditional paintings. They were good, but I thought they were like very simple when we look at tribal art and all. It's very, to make it, it's quite simple. And I wanted, capture the depth of the nature. So I think they should just figure out what works best for them and what they like to paint as well.
Yeah, that's true.
Then, yeah. After they figure out their style, I think it will be easier.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I also feel that. Like, that's the reason why I've been trying different things, because I feel that I don't have my own style yet. I do a lot of feminist-oriented paintings, but then nothing, like, which I can say that this is my style. So I try everything. I've been trying everything till now. But then hopefully someday I'll have my own style.
Now, what I like in your painting is that you paint quite, you use big canvases, right?
Yeah.
I've never tried that. I mean, what is it like? I mean, painting on such big canvases. I do want to try it though.
It is really good. Like, if you have that kind of idea what you want to do, I think it's pretty easy. And having that whole easel and then stepping back every time you put a layer, that helps a lot. And that's what helps me a lot. And for me, small canvases have always been a huge challenge for me. I'm more of a big canvas kind of a person. For me, it's more easy to do big stuff rather than small stuff. Like, if you ask me to do a miniature painting, I will struggle. So, because whenever I draw or whenever I sketch things, it is always like, if I see a picture, my sketch will be like twice or three times bigger than what I'm seeing. That's how I have always done. So it's like, for me, small paintings are huge huge challenge, but then big canvases are more easy for me. And I think you should definitely try. Like, don't hold it. Try it and then see how you feel, whether you like it or not. Because sometimes you might like it, sometimes you might not like it. And as I said, for me, small canvases, I don't like. I like big canvases.
I mean, even in small canvases, when I paint, I usually have to do like 2-3 layers so that the canvas doesn't show through. So that would be an issue in the big canvas as well, right? So, and it would take a long time.
And then you need to be fit as well. Like, initially I did have easel, but sometimes I try to put it on the ground and I try to paint it. So I have to move quite a bit around the canvas. Like, I have to get up a lot and then move to a different corner and stuff. So it's quite challenging in that way as well, but I really enjoy big canvases. Yeah, hopefully we can see a big canvas in our store very soon from you.
Yeah, definitely. I'll try.
So you are a PhD student, right? How do you make time?
I mean, I don't think I need to make time, because this is one of my passions. So, like, whenever I'm stressed out, I turn to, I either read books or I directly go to painting. So it's like it's a stress buster for me. So it's not like I have to make specific time for it. Like, my mind actually figures out this time is free, so just go to painting. So
That's very good, actually. So whenever you feel like, okay, this is the time, like, I'm stressed out or I just need a break or anything, you just straight away head to your painting, is it?
Yeah, I have a few things that I do like to do when I'm not working, and painting is one of them. So
yeah, that's good. So are you doing any painting as of now?
Yesterday there was a solar eclipse. So I was inspired by that. I wanted to capture the solar eclipse on my canvas. So right now I'm doing that. I've just made the initial sketch and the first layer of painting is done. That's all. It still needs a few more hours to complete it.
Okay, that's good. Yeah. So where do you get your art supplies from?
I usually go to the local stores that I find here. During the lockdown I ordered it online. Otherwise, there's a, in Commercial Street in Bangalore, there's this Reliance Fine Art.
Yeah,
they have a very wide range of art supplies, and the staff there, they're very helpful. So, like, I usually go there, I talk to them, so, and then they help me pick out whatever I need.
Okay, yeah, that's good. I didn't know that Commercial Street had an art store which was that big. Yeah. Okay, so that's really nice to know. And so if people have to find your art, where can they find it?
Mostly in your store. Otherwise, I don't use... Sorry?
On Flaunter Art, yeah.
Right, mostly on Flaunter Art. Otherwise, I am on social media. I use only Facebook. And I usually post whatever I paint there. So these are the only two ways I guess they can find my painting.
Yeah, definitely. All you people, if you want to find Lakshita's paintings, it is there on Flaunter Art. And it's actually at, like, some of them are on 50% off right now on the website. So it's a great deal, actually. Yeah. And to be honest, like, the Cosmic one, people loved it so much. And there were a lot of inquiries for the Cosmic, because it's truly very beautiful. And it is very different when you actually see a picture online. And when you see the texture, when you're holding it, it's completely different. And some of the local markets, they really liked it.
I'm really glad.
So, yeah. So that's the questions that I had. Anything else do you want to talk or?
I mean, if anyone wants to try painting or any form of art, I would just suggest them to go for it. I mean, it's not necessary to turn every hobby into a profession. So, like, just do it, like, you know, just go for it. Watch a lot of videos and everything is available very quite easily nowadays. So I would tell them just go for it.
Yeah, that's good. And do you practice art every single day or?
No, I paint at least, I try to paint at least 2 times a week, but it usually depends on my mood, I guess.
Yeah. And I feel that practicing makes a lot of difference, isn't it? So I at least draw, even if it is a very small sketch or anything, I try to do every single day. Like even though, like I have thousands and thousands of sketchbooks, I don't use the same sketchbook, which is like a big problem because I don't have space. And I have a lot of wasted sketchbooks everywhere, but at least I feel that it's important to sketch at least something or be creative in some way, like even writing or something. That helps a lot. That's... Yeah.
If I'm not painting, I at least look at, like I said, I keep looking at stuff that I should buy for painting, or I keep watching videos before I sleep. So that is what I do. If I'm not able to paint, I take a lot of inspiration from Pinterest or YouTube. Google search in general.
Yeah, that's true. And do you want to try any other medium in future, like other than acrylics? And you have tried
oil, definitely.
Oil. Yeah. People who use
oil. It's quite difficult to work with, but
yeah, I hope to go and take some classes someday on oil painting. Yeah, because I don't think I can actually learn without taking classes. I think it's really important, like, to get that basics right, because I really don't understand anything about oil as of now. Nothing.
Yeah, even I've never bought an oil painting in my lifetime. So, you know.
Yeah.
It's quite intimidating, I guess.
Yeah. Anyway, thank you so much, Lakshita. Thanks a lot for making time on a Friday evening. It's Friday evening in Sydney. So we're almost winding up and we have a long weekend coming up. Next weekend. So yeah, have a good weekend and hope to catch you soon.
Thank you for having me.
See ya.
Bye.